Here is my start file working with tables. You can download the exercise file and follow along by clicking on the link below this video. In this tutorial, I'll be talking about creating tables in Access, and there are four main methods for creating tables. Method number one, whatever you want to create, you go to the Create tab. So if I click on the Create tab, I have different groups. I have a group for creating tables, queries, forms, reports. Let's start by creating table. And let's say I want to create a table that stores client information. So I click on the table icon and automatically Access creates a placeholder for a table. And because Access knows that at least I need a primary key or a unique identifier, then it creates the first field and it names it ID. And it is of an auto number data type. Let's say the first field should be the client or the company name. Then I click where it says click to add. And when I click here, I see the different data types. I'll be selecting short text. A short text can accommodate up to 255 characters. When I click on short text, it creates a new field and I'll be typing company name. I can create another field to store the name of the contact person. I can do the same exact thing by clicking on the down pointing arrow and select short text, or I can go up at the top to the fields tab of the ribbon. And from here, I have the different data types. I'll be selecting short text as well, and I'll be typing contact person. Now I would like to add a bunch of fields to accommodate for the client address. So I have a street address, and then I have a city, a region, a postal code. Instead of adding them one by one, I can put my blinking cursor where it says click to add. And this time I go to the fields tab of the ribbon, click on the down pointing arrow for more fields. And from here, I go down to quick start category. So when I scroll down, I have a quick start. If I select address, then I'll be adding a bunch of fields with one single click. Should you wish to delete one of them? So let's assume that all our clients are from the same country. Then I can delete the country and region field by selecting it. And then on the ribbon, I click on the delete icon. Let's add another bunch of fields. Let's say for the phone number, which could be a business phone, a home phone, a cell phone, a fax number. Instead of adding them one by one, I put my blinking cursor where it says click to add. I go to more fields one more time. And from here, I scroll down to quick start and I select phone. And I would have added a bunch of fields. I want to save this table, so I hover over the tab of the table, and then I right-click, and then I select Save, and let's save it with the name Clients. Once the table has been saved, it appears in the navigation pane to the left side, and then I can start testing my table. Let's say for the company name, I'll be typing Best Buy, and then I hit Tab. For the contact person, I'll be typing Nabil Murad, and then I can skip a field. Let's say for the city, I'll be typing, and then for the province, I'll be typing Ontario, and then I can skip whatever I want, and now I can close my table. No one will ask me to save because I already saved the structure of the table when I assigned the name. So that was the first method, creating a table in datasheet view. I can also create a table in design view by going also to the Create tab of the ribbon. And on the Create tab, I click on Table Design. And in the empty grid, I'll be typing the field name and selecting the data type. So let's assume I'm creating a table to store students' information. The first field will be named LNG Student ID. In a previous tutorial, I talked about the universal convention of naming fields in Access called the Hungarian notations, where you use a descriptive name, you omit the spaces, you capitalize the first letter of each word, and then you use the abbreviated data type in lowercase as a prefix for each name. For the LNG item ID, that's a long integer, I'll be using an auto number data type. So if I click under data type, I can select the proper data type, which is auto number. And because I intend to use this field as a unique identifier, I want it to increment automatically, and that's the advantage of the auto number data type. For the next field, let's say it's the student first name, so I'll be typing str first name, and that will be a short text. Then I'll be adding a field for the last name, str last name. That will be a short text. It accommodates 255 characters. And let's say the date of birth for each student. That will be a date and time field. So I type DTM date of birth. And for the data type, that will be a date and time field. Let's add a field for the tuition, CUR tuition. And that will be a currency field. And finally, let's add a field for the comments. So I'll be typing MEM comments. Why am I typing MEM? I'll be selecting a long text, and a long text can accommodate up to 65,536 characters. The old name of long text until Office 2013 was a memo field, and the abbreviation coming from the old name memo is MEM, and then the name of the field is comments. The next step will be assigning the primary key. The primary key is a unique identifier. It's the leftmost field of any table, and we use it for connecting tables together and creating relationships. So to assign a primary key, I'll be selecting the first field, and then on the Design tab, I click on this primary key icon. Automatically, an icon appears to the left side. For each one of these fields, I need to provide a user-friendly name. This is what we call the caption. And it appears in the lower part, the properties section. So I select the fields one by one, and then I go to the caption property. I'll be naming the first one ID, and then I select the first name. I go to the caption property, and I'll call it first name. And then I select the next one, last name. I go to the caption property, and I'll make it last name. The user will see this user-friendly version of the name. For the date of birth, let's make the caption DOB, and then let's go to the tuition, and let's make the caption fees, and let's go to the comments, and let's make the caption notes. I finished creating my table, and I want to test it, and to test it, I need first to save it, so I click on the save icon, and I'll be naming it students. When I hit OK, then the students table appears in the navigation pane, and I can switch to datasheet view. As we learned in the previous tutorial, we can switch between the different views either from the upper left, I click on the views icon, or from the lower right corner. Now look at the structure of my table. I have ID, first name, last name, DOB, fees, and notes. I want to test my table, so I'll be typing for the first name, and then I hit tab. Look at the ID field, it increments automatically because of the auto number data type. And then I'll be typing the last name. For the date of birth, because I assigned the proper data type, then I get a date picker. I can select any date, and whatever the number of users, we guarantee that the format of the date will be identical. And then I go to the fees field. Let's type the fees, and because I assigned the proper data type, then the fees is rounded up, it has a dollar symbol and two decimal places. I'll be closing this table. And that was method number 2 for creating tables in Design View. Method number 3 for creating tables is by copying an existing table. So what if I copy table order item and I want to paste it? So I can simply select it in the navigation pane and then right-click and select copy. And then right-click and select paste. When I select paste, I'll be given 3 options to paste. So I click on paste. First of all, I need to name it, order details. And Access is asking me, what would you like to paste? Would you like to paste just the structure, which means the field name and the data type, or the structure and the data inside this table, or you just want to append the data to an existing table? I want to paste just the structure. So if I select structure only, I hit OK. Now here is the order details table. If I open it, now I see a table with the same exact structure and data type and field names, but it has no records. I can close this table. Method number 4 for creating a table is by importing it from another application. And we go in this case to the external data tab. And on the external data tab, I have 2 groups. I have an import and an export group. In the import group, I'm looking for the Excel icon. It might be displayed directly in some versions. In other versions like mine, I click on New Data Source from File and I select Excel. A wizard pops up, and in this wizard, I need to browse to the location of the file, so I click on Browse. I have my file in the Documents folder. Inside Access Basic, the file name is Student Accounts. I select it and hit Open. I have three options, either importing the source data into a new table in the current database, or appending the record from the Excel file into an existing table, or just creating a link. I'll select the first option and hit OK. And in the first window of the wizard, I have a very important option. I need to check the box, first row contains column header. Look what happens when I uncheck it. Keep an eye on this part. When I uncheck it, it doesn't create headers. So when I check it, and because I know that at the Excel end I do have some column headers, then these will become field names in Access. When I hit on Next, here it's just asking about the different data types. So I'm going to accept the default and click on Next. And because Access knows that we need a unique identifier, an extra column will be added when I hit Next. When I hit Next, Access added an ID column to be used as a primary key or a unique identifier. Actually, I don't need it because I planned for that, and I do have a column with a unique identifier at the Excel end. Then I'm going to select the second option, and this column will be gone. I click on Next, and I'm done. I'll accept the default, which is the sheet name in Excel, and when I hit Finish, an extra table will be added. Access is now asking me if I intend to repeat the import steps in case I make changes to the Excel file and I want to re-import it. I'm not saving anything, so I hit Close. And here at the Accounts table, I can open it and look at it. This is the table coming from Excel. So in this tutorial, we learned four different methods for creating a table in Access, either by going to the Create tab and click on Table and create the table in Datasheet view, or by going to the Create tab and click on Table Design and create the table in Design View and use the developer name of the field and assign a user-friendly caption. Method number three is to copy and paste an existing table. Method number four is by going to the External Data tab and importing a table from Excel.